Welcome everyone. Today we are having a look at the D-Link DWR920V wireless router. This is a wireless N300 4G LTE router which acts as your personal Wi-Fi hotspot, allowing you to share your 4G LTE connection with your wireless clients. So if you turn the box around, you'll find a list of all the features that are there. You can see that it supports integrated voice functionality, acts as a hotspot, and has gigabit ports. So let's just go ahead and open the box and check out the contents. So as you can see, there's the router. So at the back of the router, you'll see the LAN port, the WAN port, and there's the phone port. So the antennas are provided separately, but you can screw them on like this. It is pretty easy. There we go. And there goes the other one. So it's quite a portable kind of a router. So apart from the router, you'll find this RJ11 or the phone cable. And this is the RJ45 or the Ethernet cable. And that is the power adapter for your router. So let's just go ahead and see how to set up this router. So at the bottom of the router, you will see the SIM card slot where you have to make sure that the orientation of your SIM card and orientation of the figure that is provided near the port is the same. And then insert the SIM card inside and give it a light press. So once that is done, you have to insert the power cable into the power port and the Ethernet cable into the LAN port. Just make sure that there are two ports here. One is the LAN port and another one is the WAN port. So you have to insert it into the LAN port. And the other end of it, you have to insert it in your laptop or desktop computer. So once these connections are done, you have to press the power button. And you can see the router is powered on. And as you can see, the 2.4 GHz LED is glowing, which means that it is emitting a Wi-Fi signal. And also the internet LED is blinking, which means your router is connected to the internet. So to begin the configuration, we'll have to open up a web browser and type in the IP address 192.168.0.1 in the address bar. So you'll be taken to the login page. The username for this device is admin, and by default there is no password, so you can keep that blank and click on sign in. So this is the home page of your router. If you want to change your network name, password, this is where you go ahead. So let's click on the setup wizard. So the first step here is where you can change your APN settings. For most people, the auto mode will suffice. You just have to keep it on auto and click next. So in this section, you can change your network name and assign it a new password. By default, there will be a network name and password assigned to your device. You can keep it as it is, but we would advise that you change it to a name that suits you better and also a password that you can remember better. So I'll go ahead and change my password to D-Link1234 and then click on next. So this is where you can set up a password for you to log into your device. As we just saw in the beginning of the wizard, we logged in with the username admin and there was no password. So you can set your own password and you have to type it twice to confirm it. Just make sure that you also remember this password. And then click on next. So there are basically two different modes for this device. As you saw, there is a WAN port and also a SIM card slot. Since we are using the SIM card right now, you have to select the 4G, 3G, 2G mode and press next. So there we go, the settings are being applied. This is a very quick and very easy setup. So once the device has finished setting up, your new network name will show in this drop-down menu. And as you can see, it is here. And if you click on that, you will be asked to enter the password, the new password which you just set. So you have to enter the password here. For me, it was DLink1234. So enter the password and click on join. So once you're connected to the network, you'll be guided back to the login page again. So as you know, the username is admin, and we had also set up a new password for this. So we have to type out that password and click on sign in. So you'll be taken to the home page again, where you can find the details of your network, your connection speed, the range of your SIM card. You'll also find details like how many clients are connected to your router on the right hand side here. So that's it, it's configured, it's absolutely simple. So just to make sure that everything is working right, let's just go open a new tab and try to access a website. And as you can see, we are already connected to the internet. So happy surfing and have a nice day.